Hello everyone, in this video I want to show you some of easy tutorial how to create an abstract geometric gradient background with Inkscape. Let's begin. Alright, first let's create a background in here with rectangle tool. Click this icon and make sure you active this snap to the pick border. You see this tooltip, just drag it to here. Change the color to this color. Press D to activate the dropper tool. Change it to this color. Or you can input this color code to here. With the rectangle tool again, click this icon. Start making a shape like this. You can change the color to this color. And press F2 to enter the edit mode. Just drag this handle to make it rounded like this. Okay. Now let's create some gradient in here with the gradient tool. Click this icon. Just drag it down. Alright, you can change this top node color by double click and press D to activate the dropper tool. Change it to this color. And for the bottom, just double click, and we are going to use the transparency. Make sure you double click first and right click, just remove fill to make sure it's become a transparent, and just drag this handle like this. Add more in here with rectangle tool again. Just make some rounded shape. You can change the color to this color. With gradient tool again, just drag it. You can change the gradient direction like this. Alright, so I'm just gonna scale it by click and Ctrl Shift S to make it scale proportional. Like this. Then just add more shapes. Next step, we're going to make it clean with intersection. So we're gonna remove all this outer part in here with intersection. So I'm just gonna duplicate this background. Press Ctrl D and hold Shift. Then click this shape and go to path, choose intersection. So now this shape is in the background, no outer. So just do the same for the here. Duplicate the background, press Ctrl D, hold shift, then click this. Go to path, choose intersection. Do the same. Next we're going to create the circle with stroke. So click the circle tool. Hold Ctrl Shift while dragging to make it a proportional scale like this. And you can swap the fill to the stroke. So no fill. By right click, choose swap fill and stroke. Increase the stroke width in stroke style. Change it to pixel. So I just put some number like this. And make it become gradient like this. So for the stroke, it's slightly different. If you try with gradient right now, it will gradient the fill, not the stroke. To do that, in fill and stroke tab, choose the stroke pane and choose this linear gradient. Now you can drag the gradient and place where you like. Duplicate this and place it on here, press Ctrl D, and you can scale it down. But when you scale it down, the stroke will increase the thickness. So in order to keep the stroke width, you have to click this so it will keep the stroke width. Alright, now press F2 to enter the edit mode. You can adjust the gradient fade and just add more. Add some circle in here with circle tool. Click this and hold Ctrl Shift. Just drag it to make it proportional scale. Then give some gradient with gradient tool. Just drag it. And you can change this node color by double click, press D, and change it to this color. Add more circle, press Ctrl D, and place it on here. Can scale it down, press Ctrl Shift to make it proportional scale. And change the gradient color to this color. And you can adjust the gradient. Right. add some rectangle in here, rectangle tool, click this. And just make it no corner, like this. And you can drag the gradient, change the color to this color. And just add more in here. Rotate it by clicking twice until you see this rotate icon, and hold Ctrl Shift while rotating to make it 15 degree increment, and place it on here. Change the color to this color. Next, we're going to create some pattern with circle shape first. In Edit Objects and Fill tab, you can choose this pattern and change the pattern fill to this. And you can rotate it by pressing Ctrl, like this, and scale it down, and just duplicate this. You can reduce the opacity by holding Shift then click, and change it to 70. If you select all of this object, it's kind of messy, it's out from the page, so make it clean with intersection. But for the stroke object like this, you cannot do the intersection right now. Let me show you what I mean. So just going to duplicate the background, press Ctrl D, and select these two, and go to Path, choose Intersection. So you see it's not performing well for the stroke. You have to convert the stroke to path first. So let me undo it, and go to Path, Stroke to Path. And try again to do intersection by duplicating this, press Ctrl D and click this, go to path, choose intersection. So now it's smooth. So I just duplicate this background and hold shift, then click this shape. Again, go to path, choose intersection. Alright, now for the last, add the text by pressing T and type, press T and Ctrl A to select all, and change the font to this Montserrat, the bold type, change the color to white, and you can adjust the spacing by pressing Ctrl A and click this. Adjust the kerning for this geometric. Let's put it 15, and for the gradient I set to 25. Place it in the center by clicking the text first and the background, hold shift then click, and go to this align and distribute objects. Choose the relative to last selected, because our last selected is the background. You can click this to center it on vertical axis, and this for the horizontal axis. Right, scale it down a little, add more text, so I just duplicate this and rename it, change the type to, and scale it down by pressing Ctrl, create some square shape with a corner, so click this square and hold Ctrl Shift to make it proportional scale, like this. Okay, you can turn up the opacity to make it full, and swap the fill to become a stroke. Let's adjust the width to, and now we're going to run one corner, not all the corner, but this only one. So click the rectangle and go to path, choose the path effect. Right, you can open this and click this add. And choose the corner, click this icon. It will active the corner effect, so press F2, and you can drag one handle like this. Let me scale it down a little. I hope you learned something new, how to create an abstract geometric gradient background with Inkscape. Just keep exploring and practicing. I'm Zakay from Zakay Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.